Namo Namaha. Swagatam Sarvebhyah. Now let's turn to one of the more straightforward of our non-aganas in the present system, which is class 5, known as the Su-gana. Here, our characteristic verb is going to be su, which means to press or push, and it has sunoti as its strong conjugation. He presses, she presses, it presses. The weak form is sunumaha, we press, we three or more. Or sunwanti, they press, they plural. As you can probably tell, the stem form formation for class 5 is going to be a bit more straightforward than class 2. Like with all the non-aganas, we're going to have two different stems. We're going to have strong and weak. Here, the difference between the two is going to be marked by actually two distinct gana markers that we put on instead of anything we do with the root itself. So there's no gunation stuff going on in class 5. You just take the root, you add the marker no to make the strong stem, or you take the root and you add the marker nu to make the weak stem. So in the case of our root su, to press, the strong stem is going to be the root su plus no, and you get su no as the strong stem. The weak stem, you're going to take the root su plus the marker nu, and you get sunu. So we get sunoti, he presses, she presses. Sunutaha, the two of them press. Sunwanti, they press, they plural. In the second person, the S sandhi rule will be triggered by that vowel O. So we, in the strong forms, we get sunoshi, you press. In the first person, we'll have aham sunomi, I press. The dual is going to be awam sunuwaha, we both press. Or wayam sunumaha, we plural press. Actually, there are some optional forms for these dual and plural uttama purusha. You can also find sunwaha and sunmaha, where the short u drops from the stem, the gana marker. This only happens with the roots that don't end in consonant, those are roots that are in CV form. An example is a very common fifth class root that you're going to see over and over again throughout Sanskrit literature, which is the root ap, where you're not going to see this. Ap means to get or obtain. To form the strong stem of ap, you take the root and you add no, so you get ap no. To form the weak stem, we take the root ap and we add the marker nu. So we get ap nu. And that's it. And then now you add your endings. Use the strong stem for the three singulars in the parasmaipada. So for third person singular, you'll have apnoti. He, she, it gets. Second person singular, you will have apnoshi. You obtain. Here, notice again, our internal S sandhi rule is triggered because of the vowel O, which forces the S to become a retroflex. The last of the strong forms is the first person singular, aham. Apno mi, I receive, I get, I obtain. All the other forms in Parasmaipada and all of the Atmanaipada is going to use the weak stem, apnu, apnutaha, the two of them obtain. For the plural, it's apnuwanti, they three or more get, obtain, or receive. Here again, when we have our u before anti, instead of the u changing into a va like we see elsewhere, the semi-vowel va is now going to get inserted in between. So we have apnu wanti. We should note here that the ap also has not just parasmaipada endings, but atmanepada, a full atmanepada conjugation. And that will only use the weak stem apnu. And we're going to have our alternate atmanepada endings, if you remember those, where we have long a instead of a in our duals in the third and second person. And we are also going to have ate instead of ante in the plural. So we can have third person singular, apnute, he gets, she gets, it gets. The dual is going to be apnuwate, the two of them get. The plural will be apnuwate, they get or obtain. Now notice here the nakara is dropped in the third person plural, and it's something that, yeah, we're going to get kind of confused by when we see it in the text. It looks like it should be singular, but it's not. Apnute is the singular, he, she, it gets. Apnuwate, they get. Just one little wakara is different, and that's it. For the second person singular, we'll have apnushe with the retroflex S, triggered again the S. Sandhi rule, you get. Dual is apnuate, the two of you get it. And plural is apnu dwe. You all get. First person's a bit more straightforward. Apnuve, I obtain. Apnuvahe, we both get something. And vayam, apnumahe, we all get something. We plural. Let's now turn to another very similar and equally important fifth class root you're going to see a lot, which is shak. And this means to be able to do something. Here the strong stem is going to be shakno, and the weak stem, shaknu. So we get shaknoti, she, he, it is able to do something. Tau shaknutaha, the two of them are able to do something, or te shaknuvanti, they three or more are able to do something. For second person, you get that S sandhi rule, and it becomes tvam shaknoshi, you are able to. Shaknutaha, you two are able to, and shaknuta, you three or more are able to do something. Aham shaknomi, I am able to. Avam shaknuvaha, the two of us are able to. And vayam shaknumaha, we are able to do something. Finally, let's turn to one irregular verb in this gana that we should pay attention to. It's going to trip us up. And this is the verb shuru, which means to listen or hear. As a root, notice that it involves the consonant R plus the short U as your vowel. But when you form the present stem, that R, U, RU, gets changed into the vocalic R, RU. And then you add NO to get the strong stem, SHURUNO. And then you add NU to that to get the weak stem, SHURUNU. Notice here again, the vocalic R makes your internal N sandhi rule go into effect, and the dental N becomes a retroflex N. So when we conjugate this in the parasmaipada, we'll have sa shurunooti, she listens. Shurunutaha, the two of them listen. The plural would be shurunuanti, they three or more listen. The wa kara comes from the internal sandhi, the u plus a. For second person, you trigger your s sandhi rule so that the dental sa becomes a retroflex sha, tvam shurunoshi, you are listening. Or in the first person, aham shurunomi, I am listening. Vayam shurunumaha, we are listening, three or more. The formation itself is regular. It's just that the root is shuru with the consonant ra and the vowel u, but the stem involves the vocalic ru, shuruno or shurunu in the present. Okay, with that, let's pause here, take a break, and then when we come back, we will turn to our next non-agana, the eighth class, which is the dan-gana, and it works a lot like the class five. So till then, thank you for watching. See you next time. Narmilamaha dhanyavadaha.